Hey there, howdy neighbor.
Hey, how you doing?
Hey, pretty good. I'm Jim Day. My family and I, we just moved in here.
Your dog is pooping on the lawn.
Oh, hey, sorry about that. Hold on a second. There you go.
Did you just use your hands?
Yeah, well, just the tips. It's all fine. Anyways, like I was saying, I'm Jim Day. My family and I, we ain't from around here, you know. Just moved in.
I could kind of tell, but I couldn't see you.
Yeah, well, you too. You know, we're just around here. If you ever, you know, want to come over, have a beer or anything, we're pretty friendly people. We'll be around.
In the city, we bump.
Oh, hey, that's cool. All right. Well, it's nice to meet you. I'll see you later.
See you around.
You're a white man.
God, country, and mama. Hey, it's our motto. It's our creed. You made it to the second episode of the Jim Day Show. I'm telling you, last week was a real number one, and I think we got just the right material to make this a real classic number two. So go ahead and sit back and enjoy this one. We got some rodeo clips for you today. I think you're going to enjoy them. We got some horses, some cows. Ain't for the faint of heart. So, you know, just be warned on that one. Hey, you ever wonder why when these days when you disagree with somebody, why they make it an issue of hate and like this personal thing, like you attacking them? Well, we're going to talk a little bit about that today. I'll give you a little secret. It's politics. All right, but we're going to talk a bit about that. We got some other funny clips. And hey, in the Jim Day family here, they moved in. They've been here for about a week. And in our clips, they getting used to living in the city. So go back, sit back, enjoy the Jim Day Show, and let's let her rip. All I gotta say, man, a lot of respect for those fellas. You know, this one side of me thinks I could get out there and I could really set my mind to it, and I can show up something, but at the end of the day, these guys are tough fellas. We'll see how long we last out there. Maybe start by going to the bars there and riding one of them riding Broncos, right? And let your delusions of grandeur start from there. But I tell you, some people, they don't like watching rodeo stuff because they're thinking that you're mean to the animals or something. I've heard these animals, they work about one time a year, and the rest of the year they just mating and getting fed. So seems like a pretty good deal for me to get out there and get around the good people, get around some good culture. We all love animals. Hey, and rodeo season coming up, so you know, I'm really jacked on that. I'm really excited about that. All right, but that being said, we're going to get in here. I told you we was going to talk a little bit about why is it that when you disagree with some people, they take it so strong, like you attacking them on a person. Well, there's a reason behind that. And, you know, what I want to do here, I'm going to show you one of these older clips that we did down at the coast. And there's a lot of reflection, right? You're sitting there staring at the ocean and reflecting on these things. So let's go over there to this video here, and we're going to talk about why do people act like this, and what can we do so that we can continue to be the better people? Because, hey, as Americans, we got to have the conversations. Always got to have the conversations, right? So we need to trust each other. All right, but let's go check this clip out.
Hey there, it's Jim today. I want you to do something for me. I want you to feel something. I want you to sit in just for a moment. Just for a moment. Take a breath. Slow down. And think of peace. What's your hope? What brings you hope? Is it, you know, maybe it's your religion. Maybe it's love. Maybe it's the thought of family. I don't know, whatever it is. But what is that feeling that brings you hope? All right, now, you got that feeling? I want you to feel it. Now I'm going to show you some people over here. Those people, they are against that feeling that you have. That feeling you have, these people over here, they are against that. Now how are you going to respond to that? You're going to be like, my God, well, they're bad people. They're trying to take away the good thing that I feel. And what's my evidence? Well, my evidence is I know what I feel. And these people are against it. Well, here's the thing. Our emotions are great. We know we gotta listen to our hearts. We gotta listen to the promptings, right? But if we do that solely, then hey, we are highly open to be manipulated. I wanna be manipulated. And in fact, that's what's taking place. People creating emotions in our hearts, and then they're saying, these people over here, they don't love you, they're bad. And then we don't gotta listen to them no more. And you want to know what? At the end of the day, that ends up promoting more racisms, more sexisms, all the isms, because you start to treat people in groups. And it's not based on any reason. It's just based on the tyranny of my heart. Because I just feel that way. But I'm being manipulated because people had me feel a certain thing, and then they told me that these people are against it. Here. On the other hand, we know you can't just figure things out through the mind and through ration, right? Because at the end of the day, we lose our heart, right? You can make the most practical decision in the world, but if it ain't the empathetic one as well, we're doing the right, then it's the wrong decision. And we know this, right? So we don't want to be just led by one, but I sure as hell don't want to be led by the other. It's almost as if, my God, if somehow I could balance my emotions with my ration, that somehow I could be a whole being that is able to make decisions based on both these things, almost like a self-correcting car. If I start to go too far to the one side, the tether kicks in and it pulls me here. And if I go too far to the one, the other pulls me in here. My God, what a mind-boggling idea, right? Except that's how it is. So let's get back to that. What we need to do is we need to hold ourselves accountable. And we need to hold others accountable too. That's gonna make us better people again. We're gonna figure out these issues. All right, Jim Day, bye.
Yeah, I tell you, I don't know how I'm gonna fit into a culture where they consider Avicii manlier music than Hank Williams Jr. Well, that's where the work is. Yeah. Yeah, kids in school. I found a park, I'm just sitting here thinking. Yeah, well, I don't know what it is I want, you know? I got married because I was tired of being alone, tired of a dirty house. Evidently, she left me for the same reasons. Yeah, you right. Lord's in the workings. All right. Well, I got to get them kids here soon. All right. Love you too, Ma.
Now I taught the weeping willow how to cry. And I showed the clouds how to cover up a clear blue sky. And the tears I cried for that woman are gonna flood you, big river. And I'm gonna sit right here until I die. I met her accidentally in St. Paul, Minnesota. And it tore me up every time I heard her drawl, southern drawl. Then I heard my dream, went back downstream, cavorting in Davenport, and I followed you, Big River, when you called. Then you took me to St. Louis, later on down a river. A freighter said she's been here, but she's gone, boy, she's gone. I found her trail in Memphis, but she just walked up the bluff. She raised a few eyebrows and went on down alone. Now won't you bat it down the Baton Rouge, River Queen, roll it on. Take that woman on down to New Orleans, New Orleans. Go on, I've had enough, dump my blues down in the Gulf. She loves you, Big River, more than me. Yes, I taught the weeping willow how to cry, cry, cry. And I showed the clouds how to cover up a clear blue sky. And the tears I cried for that woman gonna flood you, Big River. And I'm gonna sit right here until I die.
All right, then. Well, that's the we come to the end of another episode of the Jim Day Show. Hey, I'm glad you're sticking around. We're going to be picking this up here more. We got more news to talk about. We got more country things to look at. Honestly, it's the culture I love. You know, I like a lot of things, but I love my culture. I love the things that I love, and I think that you're going to find those things here that you enjoy as well. So go ahead, like, share, and subscribe this these episodes. Hey, it really helps when you get the word out there. Ain't no better word of mouth than word of mouth. So go ahead and put that out there. We love it on you. And as always, you stay good. Well, we made it through our first week, kids. What was some new experience you had here in the city?
Oh, I joined a robotics club.
Hey, well, that's good. That's good. How about you, Catherine?
I kissed my first boy today.
You did what?
Just kidding. Or am I?
Catherine. How about you, Emily? What's something new you did?
I chased a squirrel around a tree.
Chased a squirrel around a tree. Well, that's a little bit weird, but I suppose that's a good one. No, I think the Lord's got us in a good place, guys.
What'd you do this week?
Oh, well, I met the neighbor today. He was a real nice fellow. Oh, actually, that reminds me. I need to go wash my hands.